All right. Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. So we're going to get started with our community conversation this evening.
Selamat sore semua. Kami sebentar lagi akan mulai dengan perbincangan masyarakat.
And again, thank you for joining and for being here.
Dan sekali lagi, terima kasih untuk bergabung.
I'm Yaralix Estrella from the New York City Department of Health and Mental Hygiene. And
Nama saya Yaralix Estrada, saya dari Departemen Kesehatan dan Departemen Mental Kesehatan.
And we're co-hosting with the Endangered Language Alliance for this evening's event.
Dan kami ikut membantu hosting bekerja sama dengan Endangered Language Alliance pada sore hari ini.
This webinar is part of a series of webinars with many community interpreters for a variety of indigenous languages.
Webinar pada sore hari ini adalah beberapa series dari webinar yang kami berikan kepada komunitas dengan berbeda dialect.
This evening we will have live interpretation into Indonesian, and in future community conversations we will have other languages.
Pada sore hari ini kami akan mempunyai acara live yang dimana akan diterjemahkan di bahasa Indonesia dan bahasa Inggris dan juga di bahasa yang lain.
We are excited to bring you all together to discuss the critical issue of the COVID-19 vaccines.
Kami sangat senang untuk bisa mendapatkan kesempatan untuk memberikan penjelasan tentang COVID-19.
I know we all have a lot of questions, and hopefully we will have the opportunity to speak about many of your concerns today.
Sekiranya jika ada pertanyaan atau kekhawatiran, kami mempersilakan Anda untuk memberikan pertanyaan.
That way, everyone can make an informed decision about the vaccines.
Dengan seperti itu, kami semua bisa membuat keputusan tentang vaksinasi.
I would like to introduce you to our Indonesian interpreters and community leaders, Tevi Marin and Wulan Del Valle.
As an interpreter, nama saya Tevi Marin. Saya mewakili Indonesian Diaspora Network, Chapter Greater New York, dan Wulan Del Valle. Salah satu penerjemah kami.
Halo, selamat malam. Nama saya Wulan. Saya akan membantu untuk menerjemahkan bersama Tevi Marin di webinar kali ini mengenai vaksin COVID-19. Hi, my name is Wulan. I will help Tevi Marin and also New York Department of Health and Mental Hygiene in this webinar session to make you understand about COVID-19 vaccines.
Thank you, Tevi and Wulan.
Merci. Thank you.
We acknowledge that this past year has been especially stressful and painful.
Kami menyadari bahwa setahun terakhir ini adalah tahun yang sulit.
The loss of loved ones, jobs, businesses, homes, and livelihoods has been an enormous weight for us all.
Kehilangan orang-orang yang tercinta kita, pekerjaan, juga kehidupan normal kita adalah beban yang berat bagi kita semua.
Many of you have also suffered from years of disinvestment, biased treatment, and lack of access.
Banyak dari kita juga mengalami ketidakadilan atau I'm sorry, can you repeat that?
Many of you have also suffered from years of disinvestment, biased treatment, and lack of access.
Okay, banyak juga yang mengalami ketidakadilan dari ketidakadilan sosial. Go ahead, Yara.
These experiences have reinforced cycles of trauma and created a lack of trust towards government and healthcare.
Pengalaman tersebut bisa menyebabkan tidak kepercayaannya terhadap pemerintah.
We empathize with those who have historically or personally experienced discriminatory treatment.
Kami merasakan apa yang Anda rasakan dan kami merasakan I'm sorry, can you repeat that?
We empathize with those who have historically or personally experienced discriminatory treatment.
kami merasakan apa yang Anda rasakan secara historical.
The work we are doing to educate and gather information for the community on vaccination is keeping these important truths in mind.
Pekerjaan yang kami lakukan sekarang untuk tetap memperbaharui pengetahuan.
We are not here to convince or force anyone to get the vaccines.
Webinar ini tidak memaksa atau meyakinkan Anda untuk mendapatkan vaksin.
But we want to provide all community members with the most up-to-date scientific information so that
Tapi kami ingin memberikan ilmu pengetahuan yang terbaru kepada masyarakat tentang vaksin.
So in that way, everyone can make an informed decision about their body.
Di mana kami berharap semua anggota masyarakat bisa mengambil keputusan dari pengetahuan tersebut.
And now I want to set and share some community agreements to ensure that we have a productive conversation.
Sebelum kami memulai webinar ini, kami ingin menjelaskan beberapa peraturan.
And the first is respect everyone's opinions and concerns.
Yang pertama, marilah saling menghormati opini dan pendapat orang lain.
Everyone's experience is valid, and we want to respect everyone's concerns tonight.
Semua pengalaman orang berbeda-beda, dan kita ingin menghormati pengalaman mereka tersebut.
And the second is, please speak one person at a time and do not interrupt anyone.
Dan yang ketiga, untuk saling menghormati orang yang berbicara, tidak saling interrupt, dan berbicara satu persatu.
Everyone will be on silent, so during the question and answer period, please use the Zoom reactions to raise your hand if you have a question.
Semuanya akan di mute. Jadi jika ada pertanyaan, tolong digunakan emoji mengangkat tangan di Zoom.
Everyone can also put their questions in the chat.
Semua juga diperbolehkan untuk memberikan pertanyaan di seksi di bagian chat. Di Zoom.
And if you're watching from Facebook Live, you can also share your questions in the comments of the video, and we'll answer them from there.
Jika Anda menyaksikan atau bergabung di live on Facebook, Anda juga bisa memberikan pertanyaan di bagian komen di bawah.
So today we want to share with you what we know about the vaccines and answer any questions that you may have.
Pada sore hari ini kami ingin membagikan pengetahuan kami tentang vaksin dan jika ada pertanyaan.
I want to introduce you to Dr. Flores, Dr. Judith Flores, doctor from Health and Hospitals, who is here with us today.
Kami ingin memperkenalkan Dr. Judith Flores. I'm sorry, which hospital is this again?
Health and Hospitals. All of them. Health New York City Health and Hospitals.
Okay, Rumah Sakit di New York City. I'm sorry. Dr. Okay. Judith Flores yang akan bergabung dengan webinar kita pada sore hari ini. Terima kasih.
We are all here to answer your questions today.
Kami semua ada di sini untuk menjawab semua pertanyaan dan kekhawatiran Anda.
So, Dr. Flores, would you like to introduce yourself before starting the presentation?
Yes, I would. My name is Dr. Judith Flores, as you already told everyone. I'm a physician that's been working in New York City during this pandemic. I am an administrator and a pediatrician, so I've taken care of a lot of children and adolescents. And in the pandemic, a lot of adults also.
Wulan?
Perkenalkan, nama saya Dr. Judith Flores. Saya bekerja di hampir semua rumah sakit yang ada di New York City. Jadi mulai dari anak kecil sampai orang dewasa, saya sudah merawat mereka selama masa pandemik ini.
So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen and show the presentation, and then Dr. Flores can begin. Thank you.
Okay, so I want to start by thanking you all for allowing us into your Facebook page and your homes so we can discuss this very important matter.
Kami ingin mengucapkan terima kasih untuk bergabung di webinar kami di Zoom atau di Facebook Live untuk mendiskusikan masalah COVID-19 vaksin.
I'm going to start with very basic information.
Saya akan memulai dengan informasi yang sangat basic.
This should make you come up with some questions at the end so we can have further discussion.
Jika ada pertanyaan di akhir webinar ini, kita akan mendiskusikan pertanyaan tersebut.
Next slide, please. So there are key messages that we'd like to share this evening.
Ada beberapa pesan yang kami ingin sampaikan pada sore hari ini.
You've all heard that the vaccine saves lives.
Kita semua tahu bahwa vaksin itu bisa menyelamatkan kehidupan.
You've all been told that they're safe and effective.
Kita juga tahu bahwa vaksin itu efektif dan aman.
The vaccines that are available to us in the United States are at no cost. They're completely free.
Dan COVID-19 vaksin ini tidak ada biaya, gratis.
And it doesn't, your immigration status does not matter.
Dan di mana tidak diperdulikan status atau masalah imigrasi Anda.
Everyone who lives in the United States can get vaccinated.
Semua orang yang tinggal di Amerika Serikat bisa mendapatkan vaksin.
And now even tourists are being vaccinated in New York.
Dan sekarang pada saat ini turis pun bisa divaksin di New York.
All the information that you have is confidential.
Semua informasi personal atau data personal yang Anda berikan akan rahasia atau confidential.
And none of what you give us when you fill out forms is shared with any agency.
Semua data personal Next. Yang Anda berikan kepada kami tidak akan dibagikan kepada agensi pemerintah lain.
Next slide, please.
Ulan.
Okay, so for now, we have three different vaccines available to us in the United States.
Untuk saat ini, kita mempunyai tiga jenis vaksin COVID-19 yang sudah tersedia di Amerika Serikat.
Two of them are very similar. Pfizer and Moderna are based on the same technology.
Dua di antaranya merupakan sangat amat mirip dikarenakan mereka menggunakan formula yang hampir sama. Jadi cara bekerjanya sangat-sangat hampir mirip, yaitu Pfizer dan Moderna.
The Johnson & Johnson Janssen is a little different in technology, in the way it's made.
Untuk vaksin Johnson & Johnson itu agak sedikit berbeda dikarenakan teknologinya yang dipakai dan cara dibuatnya.
But what's important to us as we get vaccinated is to know the following.
Yang terpenting untuk kita adalah bukan dari jenis vaksinnya, tapi merupakan efek yang dapat apa yang bisa melindungi diri kita oleh vaksin ini.
All three of these vaccines have gone through the same process of review.
Semua ketiga vaksin COVID ini sudah melalui berbagai macam proses dan riset dan juga uji klinik.
They've had to undergo the same testing, and they've had the same result.
Ketiga jenis vaksin ini harus harus melewati tes yang sama, dan hasilnya pun juga sama.
The purpose of these vaccines. It's very specific to avoid severe disease, hospitalization, and death.
Keutamaan ketiga vaksin ini intinya itu adalah untuk menghindari penyakit serius akibat COVID-19 seperti opname, rawat inap, maupun juga kematian.
In the world, we are still in the middle of this pandemic. People are still dying and being very sick throughout the globe.
Pada saat ini, seluruh dunia, termasuk di Amerika, masih dalam masa pandemik. Masih banyak orang yang sakit di rumah sakit, dan masih banyak juga, dan masih tingginya kematian akibat COVID-19 di seluruh dunia.
It's amazing that we have something that will keep us out of the hospital and alive. It is amazing.
Dan ini sebenarnya sangat amat beruntung untuk kita karena kita bisa mempunyai vaksin untuk agar kita terhindar dari penyakit serius akibat COVID-19 supaya kita bisa tetap hidup dan kita tetap sehat dan dijauhkan dari rumah sakit.
Okay. This is not the case throughout the world. Many countries have no access to vaccine and are in the middle of this terrible pandemic.
Ya, dan sangat disayangkan masih banyak dan banyak negara-negara lain yang belum mendapatkan vaksin, tidak adanya akses vaksin seperti kita yang berada di Amerika Serikat.
Next slide, please. Thank you. So there are many things we know about this vaccine, and there's many things we're learning about these vaccines.
Ada banyak hal yang sudah kita ketahui tentang vaksin COVID-19, tapi ada beberapa hal juga yang kita belum ketahui mengenai vaksin COVID-19.
So it's important to know that COVID-19 has the number 19. It started in 2019.
Patut diketahui kenapa namanya COVID-19 dikarenakan COVID-19 itu ditemukan pertama kali pada tahun 2019.
And in January of 2020, the vaccine work began.
Dan pada tahun 2020, bulan Januari, vaksin COVID-19 mulai di tes.
So the story has gone on for quite a while. People trying to develop safe, effective vaccines throughout the world.
Jadi sebenarnya vaksin COVID-19 ini sudah diteliti sejak tahun 19. Di seluruh dunia. Jadi ini bukan semata-mata vaksin baru yang saja ditemukan.
And it's amazing that we now have several vaccines that can keep us alive and out of the hospital.
Dan betapa beruntungnya dan sangat baiknya kita mempunyai 3 pilihan jenis vaksin COVID-19 untuk menjauhkan kita dari penyakit serius COVID-19, rumah sakit, dan juga kematian.
But the work continues, so we're still learning about these vaccines.
Dan tapi kita tetap terus akan mempelajari vaksin-vaksin ini.
We know they're safe, we know they're effective, we need to learn how long they last.
Kami tahu vaksin ini aman, efektif, dan tapi kita masih sedang mencari tahu berapa lama vaksin ini bisa melindungi kita, tenggat waktunya berapa lama sampai kita membutuhkan vaksin lagi.
Every day, people that have received this vaccine are being studied. Every day.
Setiap hari, tidak pernah berhenti. Semua orang yang sudah mendapatkan vaksin COVID-19 ini selalu kita teliti dan kita pelajari.
This will tell us how long we have, what the protection is, and if we need boosters later.
Hal ini untuk kita mendapatkan informasi apakah kita akan mendapatkan booster lainnya seperti vitamin atau vaksin dosis berikutnya. di masa yang akan datang.
Yeah, and we've all seen that the CDC and New York State are telling us that people that are fully vaccinated have more protection and probably don't transmit the vaccine as much as we thought. But we are learning about that.
Dan sudah terbukti seperti yang sudah pernah di publish oleh CDC dan New York State juga, bahwa mereka yang sudah mendapatkan vaksin COVID-19 sudah terbukti dapat meringankan penyebaran virus COVID-19 terhadap orang lain.
Thank you. Go to the next slide. Okay. All right, I want to show a slide that's a little complicated.
Saya ingin memberikan informasi pada slide ini yang informasinya cukup rumit.
People always ask me, how could this vaccine be produced so quickly?
Banyak pertanyaan yang datang kepada saya, bagaimana caranya vaksin-vaksin ini bisa diproduksi dengan jangka waktu yang singkat.
And if you look at this complicated picture, it shows you what the COVID mRNA vaccine is like and what the older traditional vaccines are like.
Pada slide ini memperlihatkan memperlihatkan tentang bagaimana vaksin COVID-19 ini dibuat dengan perbandingannya dengan tradisional vaksin-vaksin lama yang vaksin-vaksin yang sudah ada cara pembuatannya.
The traditional method is very slow.
Vaksin tradisional itu sangat amat lama cara pembuatannya.
Because it depends on getting many resources, lots of money, and lots of people working together.
Jadi untuk tradisional vaksin itu bahan-bahannya itu sangat lama untuk pengumpulan bahannya, banyak juga pekerja, banyak orang dan tim yang membuat vaksin tradisional ini. Dan juga menghabiskan banyak biaya.
The exciting part about these vaccines is that they were produced quickly and in collaboration with many, many people throughout the world.
Dan untuk vaksin COVID ini, kita banyak bekerja sama dengan seluruh pekerja kesehatan atau peneliti di seluruh dunia.
Many nations, many companies, many medical professionals got together to bring this work done, to make this work quickly, to do this work quickly.
Semua di semua pekerja kesehatan, perusahaan-perusahaan pengobatan, dokter-dokter dan semuanya bekerja sama khusus untuk pengadaan vaksin ini.
But remember, they had to meet every standard that every vaccine needs to meet to be approved. Everything had to be met.
Semuanya, namun yang walaupun banyak kerjasama dari seluruh dunia, tetap mempunyai standar prosedur dan semuanya harus bertemu di tengah-tengah.
It's almost like building a house. When you have just a little money, it takes you a while to build your house. You have to wait. When you have a lot of resources and a lot of money and a lot of workers, your house will become a skyscraper quickly.
Seperti halnya membangun rumah. Kalau kita membangun rumah, kita sendiri atau hanya sedikit bantuan untuk membangun rumah, rumah itu akan menjadi rumah dalam waktu yang cukup lama. Tapi kalau misalkan ada banyak bala bantuan berbagai macam sumber, maka rumah itu akan cepat jadi.
The vaccines were based on technology that has existed over 10 years.
Jadi pembuatan vaksin ini berdasarkan teknologi pembuatan vaksin yang sudah ada sekitar 10 tahun.
They've been based on things that were other vaccines are very similar. Some vaccines for Ebola have been developed like this. Other vaccines have been developed and have been very successful. So it's not a new technology. It's been around a long time.
Jadi patut diketahui vaksin ini bukan vaksin yang benar-benar baru. Ini merupakan vaksin yang sudah lama ada teknologinya dipakai. Contohnya seperti untuk vaksin Ebola, teknologinya juga memakai vaksin ini.
The traditional way is to use a few people and do testing for many years. The way you can do that.
Jadi cara tradisional vaksin yang lama itu adanya vaksin lalu diteliti kepada orang-orang, diberikan kepada orang-orang dan diteliti, tapi sangat amat lama, satu persatu dan dalam tenggat waktu yang lama.
The way that these COVID vaccines were developed were to use thousands of people at the same time from many countries, many groups, many races, many ethnic groups, and many ages.
Untuk vaksin COVID ini penelitiannya sangatlah singkat dikarenakan penelitiannya secara massal dari berbagai macam negara, berbagai macam grup etnis dan juga berbagai macam ras. Jadi kami meneliti ribuan orang dalam waktu yang bersamaan.
There are many vaccines that have been tested throughout the world that will not get approval in the United States. Only 3 vaccines got approval in the United States. It is that difficult.
Jadi sebenarnya ada lebih banyak vaksin lagi yang ada di seluruh dunia. Namun yang lolos dan boleh masuk di Amerika Serikat hanya ada 3. Vaksin-vaksin merek dan jenis lain itu tidak bisa masuk Amerika Serikat.
Next slide, please. So how do these vaccine work? And I'm going to focus on the Pfizer and Moderna, the mRNA vaccine.
Slide ini kami akan menjelaskan bagaimana vaksin ini bekerja, terutama untuk Pfizer dan Moderna.
These vaccines work in a non-traditional way.
Vaksin ini bekerja dengan cara yang tidak tradisional.
It's very, very simple.
Sangat sangat mudah, sangat simple.
The vaccine only has a copy of the protein from the virus in a little fat. That's it. It's a very simple vaccine.
I'm sorry, can you repeat that again, Dr.?
Yes, the vaccine is very simple.
Our vaccine is sangat simple.
It is composed of a copy.
Terdiri dari bagian copy
of the protein.
Dari protein
from the COVID virus.
Dari virus COVID tersebut.
In an envelope of fat.
Can you explain that? I'm sorry.
Sure. In the vehicle, what carries the protein is a little piece of fat.
Oh, jadi di bagian lemak yang membawa virus vaksin tersebut.
There is no live virus in this vaccine.
Tidak ada virus yang hidup di dalam vaksin tersebut.
There's no kill virus in this vaccine.
Kill virus? Can you explain that? Sorry.
There's no virus that has been changed. in this vaccine?
Tidak ada virus yang sudah diubah di dalam vaksin ini.
There is no way to get COVID from this vaccine.
Tidak bisa mendapatkan COVID atau virus dengan vaksin ini.
What the vaccine does is teach your body to make that little piece of protein.
Jadi vaksin ini mengajarkan kepada tubuh kita untuk membuat protein tersebut.
Then your body develops an army of antibodies.
Dan setelah itu tubuh Anda membentuk semacam kayak kelompok atau grup dari antibody.
The vaccine then helps your body recognize the virus and protect you.
Dan setelah itu tubuh Anda mengajarkan untuk mengetahui virus di dalam tubuh Anda.
Next slide. So I'm going to go through this very quickly because right now anybody 12 years and over can get vaccinated in the United States.
Sorry. Saya akan membahas slide ini dengan cepat karena pada saat ini sejak Mei 10 anak-anak yang sudah berumur 12 tahun bisa divaksinasi.
Children 12 to 18 must bring a guardian or parent's permission.
Anak-anak dan remaja yang berumur dari 12 sampai 18 tahun harus membawa orang tua atau wali.
And they will be receiving
vaksinasi. I'm sorry.
It's okay. No, thank you. Thank you. And they will be receiving the Pfizer vaccine.
Dan mereka akan menerima vaksin Pfizer.
Johnson & Johnson and Moderna can be given to people 18 and over.
Tetapi vaksin Moderna dan Johnson & Johnson hanya bisa diberikan kepada remaja atau anak-anak yang berumur lebih dari 18 tahun atau masyarakat yang berumur 18 tahun ke atas.
Again, you don't need insurance, you will not get a bill, but you should bring proof of something that tells us that you live in New York.
Sekali lagi kami tekankan bahwa Anda tidak perlu mempunyai asuransi karena ini gratis. Satu hal yang harus Anda punya adalah bukti bahwa Anda tinggal atau reside di New York.
Next slide.
Slide selanjutnya.
Where can I get vaccinated?
Di mana saya bisa mendapatkan vaksin?
Probably everywhere at this point.
Pada saat ini Anda bisa mendapatkan vaksin di mana saja.
Many people get vaccinated at work.
Banyak yang mendapatkan vaksin di tempat kerja.
Many people can get vaccinated at any one of the city hospitals.
Banyak yang bisa mendapatkan vaksin di rumah sakit di kota New York.
The state, New York City Department of Health has many clinics, pop-up sites all over the city.
Pemerintahan kota New York sudah menyediakan banyak tempat untuk mendapatkan vaksin.
Pharmacies.
Di farmasi, di apotek.
Your healthcare clinic.
Di klinik rumah sakit Anda.
And your own doctor can order the vaccine for you.
Dan jika Anda mempunyai dokter, Anda juga bisa untuk meminta mendapatkan vaksin.
In the chat, we have more specific information as to where you can get vaccinated.
Pada bagian chat di bawah ada informasi yang lebih detail di mana Anda bisa mendapatkan vaksin.
You can go to Vaccine Finder and make an appointment or find a site.
Anda bisa melihat di Vaccine Finder di mana di bagian chat di bawah Anda bisa mendapatkan atau pergi ke tempat vaksin membuat appointment atau membuat waktu kapan bisa datang untuk mendapatkan vaksin.
So it's so much easier now, and I'm so happy that many more people can get vaccinated without having just to go to the internet.
Without going to what, Dr. Florence?
The internet.
Oh, okay. Jadi pada saat ini, saya sangat senang bahwa banyak masyarakat bisa lebih mudah untuk mendapatkan vaksin dari di mana saja, tidak hanya dari internet.
So, in the chat, you'll find the phone number.
If you call that, di bagian di bawah, Anda bisa mendapatkan informasi tentang nomor telepon.
If you call that number, you will get a response in many, many languages. So please be encouraged to get your vaccine.
Jika Anda melihat bagian chat di bawah, ada disediakan nomor telepon di mana Anda bisa menelpon dan menghubungi nomor telepon tersebut. Anda dapat bisa mendapatkan bantuan di berbagai bahasa.
Next slide, please.
Slide selanjutnya.
So these are the steps, and basically we've gone through some of this already. The most important thing is to remember.
Slide bagian sekarang ini sepertinya kita sudah bahas cara-cara untuk mendapatkan vaksin. Yang saat ini yang lebih penting adalah cara mengingatnya di untuk menghubungi nomor telepon atau di Vaccine Finder.
To bring proof of residence in New York is very important, and to be sure to bring a parent or a guardian if you're under the age of 18.
Dan satu hal lagi yang paling penting adalah untuk membawa bukti atau proof of residence, bukti tempat tinggal di New York, dan jika Anda untuk yang berumur 12 sampai 18 tahun, untuk tidak lupa membawa umur 12 sampai 18 untuk orang tua atau wali.
If you receive the Pfizer or Moderna vaccine, you will be having two doses.
Jika Anda menerima vaksin Moderna atau Pfizer, Anda akan mendapatkan dua dosis.
The Pfizer, you will get the second dose in about 3 weeks, and Moderna in about 4 weeks.
Jika Anda mendapatkan vaksin Pfizer, dosis kedua akan diberikan 3 minggu setelahnya. Dan Moderna, jika Anda mendapatkan Moderna, dosis kedua akan diberikan 4 minggu setelahnya.
Remember, you need to get your second dose if you have a Pfizer or Moderna.
Tolong diperhatikan bahwa Anda sangat perlu untuk mendapatkan dosis kedua.
You may have a reaction with the second dose.
Anda kemungkinan akan mendapatkan reaksi, efek samping.
You may have a swelling in your arm.
Anda kemungkinan akan mendapatkan memar atau lebam.
You may feel a little feverish or fatigued.
Di tangan Anda, lemar atau lebam di tangan Anda, merasa capek, merasakan demam.
But unless you get the second dose, you are not fully protected and completely immunized.
Tetapi jika Anda tidak mendapatkan dosis kedua, Anda tidak sepenuhnya mendapatkan perlindungan atau proteksi atau immunity.
Thank you. We'll go to the next one.
Kita akan selanjutnya ke slide selanjutnya.
This is a picture of the NYC Vaccine Finder that I spoke about before, and you see you can select your language.
Di sini kita bisa lihat gambar dari Vaccine Finder, di mana saya sudah jelaskan tadi. Anda bisa menghubungi site tersebut dengan bantuan dari berbagai bahasa.
If you put in your zip code,
jika Anda memasukkan kode pos,
you can find a place near you to vaccinate.
Anda bisa menemukan tempat terdekat.
Okay, next.
Di mana Anda dapat mendapatkan vaksin. Selanjutnya.
Next slide, please. Next slide. So I already spoke about the second dose and the importance.
Saya sudah berbicara atau menyinggung tentang betapa pentingnya mendapatkan dosis kedua.
If you have a Pfizer or Moderna, as I said, you need two doses.
Seperti yang tadi sudah saya sebutkan, jika Anda mendapatkan Pfizer atau Moderna, Anda membutuhkan mendapatkan dosis yang kedua.
If you have Johnson & Johnson, you need one dose.
Jika Anda mendapatkan Johnson & Johnson, Anda hanya butuh satu dose.
But you're not fully vaccinated, you're not complete until 14 days after your last dose.
This is for Johnson & Johnson?
Everyone. For Johnson & Johnson and Pfizer and Moderna, you're not completely vaccinated until 14 days after your last dose, be it the second dose of Pfizer and Moderna or the first dose of Johnson & Johnson.
Jadi setelah Anda mendapatkan Pfizer, Moderna, atau Johnson & Johnson, Anda tidak sepenuhnya terlindungi jika Anda tidak melengkapi 14 hari dari dosis terakhir.
Thank you. Next slide, please.
Terima kasih. Slide selanjutnya.
So after vaccination,
setelah vaksinasi,
it is really the most important thing you can do to keep yourself safe, your family safe, and all of us safe.
Hal yang penting dari vaksinasi adalah untuk menjaga diri Anda aman, keluarga Anda, dan semua orang yang di sekitar Anda aman.
COVID is not going away.
Pardon?
COVID is not going away. The virus is not going away.
Virus COVID-19 tidak hilang, tidak lenyap.
In order for us to protect ourselves as a world, we need to have more people vaccinated.
Untuk kita melawan virus ini secara bersama, kita memerlukan semua orang untuk semua masyarakat, semua orang untuk divaksinasi.
So it's important that you know after vaccination.
Sangat sangat penting untuk tahu setelah vaksinasi.
You still need to have certain precautions.
Anda masih dibutuhkan untuk melakukan beberapa pencegahan, precautions.
People that are completely vaccinated 2 weeks after their last dose.
Semua orang yang sudah divaksinasi 2 minggu setelah dosis terakhir mereka.
Can do so many things now.
Mereka bisa melakukan banyak hal saat ini.
With some exceptions.
Dengan pengecualian tertentu.
There may be they need to wear a mask.
Mereka masih membutuhkan untuk memakai masker.
And keep distance, keep the 6-foot distance if they can.
Menjaga jarak.
In certain situations.
Menjaga jarak di tempat-tempat tertentu atau di lingkungan tertentu.
When they travel.
Jika mereka traveling atau berpergian.
In the subway.
Di subway.
And buses.
Di bis.
Airplanes.
Di pesawat.
Schools.
Di sekolah.
When you're indoors in a movie theater or concerts, you have to still wear your mask.
Jika Anda berada dalam bioskop, di teater atau di konser, Anda masih direkomendasikan untuk memakai masker.
The only time you can really take the mask off and be comfortable is when you're around people that are completely vaccinated. That's 2 weeks after their last dose.
Anda bisa merasakan nyaman atau membuka masker Anda di mana di selingkungan orang-orang yang sudah divaksinasi 14 hari setelah dosis terakhir.
So I've noticed a lot of people are very confused now.
Saya merasa banyak orang yang kebingungan pada saat ini.
They don't know whether to wear their mask or not.
Mereka masih bingung apakah mereka berpikir kita harus pakai masker atau tidak.
Even when they're completely vaccinated.
Walaupun mereka sudah divaksinasi penuh.
I think we have to start getting used to new habits. And it takes time.
Dan saya merasa kita harus membuat habit baru, kebiasaan baru.
But there are very good habits that we can keep.
Dan masih banyak kebiasaan bagus yang harus kita simpan, harus kita lakukan.
When you're in a place with a lot of people, you don't know if they're vaccinated.
Di tempat di mana kita tidak tahu apakah orang-orang di sekitar kita divaksinasi atau belum atau tidak.
So if you're very close to them, it's probably smart to keep your mask on.
Jika Anda tidak tahu apakah orang di sekitar Anda sudah divaksinasi atau belum atau tidak, saya merasa lebih aman jika Anda tetap memakai masker Anda.
Washing our hands often is a very good idea.
Mencuci tangan kita sesering mungkin adalah hal atau ide yang bagus.
We've had almost no flu this year because we kept these habits.
Kalau menurut saya, tahun ini atau musim ini kita tidak mempunyai flu atau influenza dikarenakan kebiasaan baik mencuci tangan dan memakai masker yang kita lakukan selama ini.
So, if we're vaccinated, why do we have to wear a mask anyway?
Dan sekarang pertanyaannya, kalau saya atau kita sudah divaksinasi, mengapa kita masih harus memakai masker?
The vaccine is doing its job by not letting us be very sick or go to the hospital.
Vaksin yang sudah kita dapat bekerja dengan tidak membuat kita sakit, dengan tidak membuat tubuh kita sakit atau pergi ke rumah sakit atau dirawat di rumah sakit.
But we still don't know if we can give the virus to someone else, even if we don't get sick.
Tetapi kita masih tidak tahu apakah kita bisa menyebarkan virus tersebut ke orang lain.
And until more people get vaccinated here and throughout the world, there is still risk.
Dan di mana masih banyak orang yang belum divaksinasi atau belum bersedia untuk divaksinasi, resikonya kita masih ada kalau kita masih bisa menularkan virus tersebut ke orang lain.
The guidance is changing, so it's good to stay informed, listen to the reports from the New York City Department of Health. They will give us some guidance.
Guidance atau peraturan yang pada saat ini masih berubah, dan jika kita ingin mengetahui yang terbaru, kabar yang terbaru, kita bisa mendengarkan dari New York City Health Department, Departemen Kesehatan New York City.
Next slide, please.
Slide selanjutnya.
So, this is what you can do next, and one thing that I want to make sure people understand is that.
Hal selanjutnya yang saya ingin tekankan, yang semua orang bisa melakukan.
We need to share things and we need to take care of our mental health. It's been a very hard year.
Kita harus berbagi, kita harus menjaga kesehatan kita, tidak hanya kesehatan tubuh, tapi kesehatan mental.
And on the screen and in the chat, we have a phone number that you can call 24 days a week, 24 days, 7 days a week, 24 hours for any help you may need. And it's totally free.
Di layar ini, kami menunjukkan ada nomor telepon yang bisa Anda hubungi. Dan juga di bagian chat di bawah, nomor telepon ini available, tersedia 24 jam sehari, 7 hari seminggu, 24/7. 24 jam sehari, 7 hari seminggu.
And you can share your story of vaccination with your family and friends and be a help to this community in New York.
Dan Anda bisa membagikan cerita atau pengalaman Anda divaksinasi kepada teman, kepada keluarga, dan kepada orang semua orang di lingkungan Anda untuk membantu masyarakat sekitar.
We're also going to put up in the chat a phone number in case you need a primary care doctor and don't have one, so that you can apply. It's free of charge and for everyone in the city. So we're going to put up that number too.
Jika Anda lihat ke bawah di bagian chat, akan ada nomor telepon di mana Anda bisa menghubungi nomor telepon tersebut untuk meminta bantuan dokter, primary doctor, dan gratis, tidak ada biaya.
And lastly, even though we hope people don't continue to get sick, if you are not vaccinated, if you have symptoms, please get tested.
Okay. Dan yang terakhir, jika Anda merasa Anda belum, Anda merasa tidak sehat dan belum divaksinasi, tolong mengambil tes.
And if you're feeling sick,
dan jika Anda,
if you're feeling sick,
dan jika Anda merasa tidak enak badan,
there is now treatment that you can get, and we'll give the phone number for that too. There are antibodies and medications that we could give you. We don't want you to stay home sick.
Ada nomor, jika Anda merasa tidak sehat, akan ada nomor telepon di mana Anda bisa hubungi untuk mendapatkan pengobatan atau antibody atau tes di mana Anda tidak usah merasa sakit atau tidak sehat di rumah sendiri.
So I want to thank the translators for their patience with me.
Saya ingin berterima kasih kepada para penterjemah yang sudah sangat sabar dengan saya.
And I will be very happy to answer any questions that you may have.
Jika ada pertanyaan dari presentasi kita hari ini, saya akan menjawab pertanyaan tersebut.
Thank you.
Terima kasih.
Thank you so much, Dr. Flores.
You're welcome.
Terima kasih, Dr. Flores.
So now we're going to open up for questions and answers.
Pada saat ini kami akan membuka forum tanya jawab.
So if anyone has any questions that they'd like to ask, you can put your questions in the chat or you can raise your hand with the reaction function.
Jika Anda ingin bertanya kepada Dr. Flores, ada bagian chat di bawah atau ada reaksi semacam tunjuk tangan ya, tunjuk jari.
So you can ask your question verbally in that way.
Dan jika Anda ingin ingin bertanya dengan tunjuk jari, Anda tidak bisa nulis secara verbal.
I think so.
I see a hand up there.
David, go ahead, David. If you want to ask a question.
Hi, David.
Hi. How are you?
Good. How are you? Talk to me.
I'm good. I want to speak with Bahasa. Because they have a translator. Nah, saya mau sharing bagaimana saya pernah kena COVID.
I'd like to share how my personal experience of getting COVID.
Yeah, satu minggu saya mencoba survive di rumah.
For 1 week, I tried to survive at home.
And then, 10 hari kemudian saya sudah nggak tahan. Saya ke CTMD di Manhattan.
Then 10 days after, I couldn't hold it anymore. So I went to CTMD in Manhattan.
Setelah di situ, dokter langsung panggil ambulans.
Then afterwards, the doctor called an ambulance.
And then masuk di dalam mobil ambulans, saya sudah collapse.
Then when I was admitted to the ambulance, I collapsed.
Yeah. 10 hari saya dalam keadaan koma.
For 10 days I was in a coma.
And then 10 hari kemudian baru saya sadar.
And then another 10 days I was conscious.
Kemudian semua organ tubuh saya tuh fail.
And my body organs failed.
Yeah. Kemudian bertahap saya dalam terapi.
Slowly I was in therapy.
Yeah, karena saya 2.5 bulan saya di rumah sakit.
Because I spent about two and a half months in the hospital.
Yeah, in the Mount Sinai Hospital, West.
In Mount Sinai Hospital.
Yeah. 2 bulan kemudian setelah saya sadar.
Kemudian, 2 months after I was conscious. Maaf Bapak David, silakan ulangi lagi.
Ya, 2 bulan setelah itu saya sadar.
2 months after that I woke up from my coma, I was conscious.
Saya dipindahkan ke bagian physical therapy.
I was transferred to physical therapy.
Yeah, because dalam 2 bulan itu badan saya itu dalam keadaan fail, mulai dari otak, jantung, ginjal, pankreas, lung.
Because during those 2 months, my body organs failed. My brain, my lung, my kidney, mm-hmm. pancreas.
Mm-hmm. Jadi sehari sebelumnya, malam besoknya dokter bilang saya akan ditransfer ke bagian physical therapy.
So the night before I was transferred to physical therapy.
Jadi sekitar jam 8 malam, saya terjadi pendarahan.
Around 8 p.m. Until, at night time, I had bleeding.
Ya, dari jam 8 malam sampai jam 3 subuh, ada 4 kali saya pendarahan.
From 8 p.m. to 3 a.m. in the morning, early in the morning, I had 4 bleedings, 4 times of bleeding.
Jadi pas pendarahan yang terakhir itu, yang keempat itu, saya dilarikan ke bagian emergency kembali.
The last bleeding that I had, I was rushed to the emergency.
Di situ saya mendapatkan 10 bungkus transfusi darah.
I received about 10 bags of blood transfusion.
Mm-hmm. And then 2,5 bungkus blood plasma blood.
Then 2.5 bags of blood plasma.
Plasma blood.
Mm-hmm. Plasma blood, sorry.
Yeah. Setelah mendapatkan 2 bungkus plasma blood, pendarahan saya semua berhenti.
After I received the 2.5 bags of plasma blood, my bleeding stopped.
Yeah. Nah, setelah itu saya dikembalikan lagi ke bagian physical therapy.
After it stopped, I was transferred back to the physical therapy.
Yeah. Besoknya saya mulai dilatih untuk berjalan karena tubuh saya seperti tidak ada tulang, tidak bisa berdiri.
The day after, I was slowly trained to walk, because of my body was limp. It seems as if I had no bones.
Weak,
very weak. Sangat lemah ya, Bapak ya?
Yeah.
Yes.
Sangat lemah.
Very weak.
Jadi seminggu saya dilatih untuk physical therapy, jalan, exercise semua.
For a week, I was trained to walk, exercise, and then all.
Yeah, jadi total saya di rumah sakit itu ada 2.5 bulan. Jadi total saya sakit itu hampir 3 bulan.
So the total I was admitted to the hospital for 2.5 months, but the whole time that I was sick, I was ill, was about 3 months.
Jadi setelah 3 bulan itu saya pulang ke rumah.
After 3 months, then I went home.
Okay. So, first of all, I'm so happy that you're talking to us because you went through practically everything that COVID can do to you.
Okay.
Bapak David, Dr. Flores merasa senang. Kalau Bapak sudah pulang lagi ke rumah.
Ya, itulah makanya saya ingin sekali share untuk pengalaman saya bagaimana.
And I'm very happy that you're with us, and I'm very sorry you had to go through this, but I'm very happy that you're with us.
Dr. Yeah. Flores sangat senang bahwa Bapak sudah bisa berkumpul lagi dengan keluarga Bapak dan bersama kami di webinar pada malam hari ini.
How long? Itulah makanya.
Yeah. How long ago was this? When did this happen?
Kapan Bapak kejadian ini?
Akhir Maret 2020.
At the end of March of 2020.
Oh. Probably the very beginning when we knew very little and we really didn't know how to take care of our patients then.
Jadi kayak permulaan COVID ya Pak, di mana kami semua kewalahan dan tidak tahu bagaimana cara merawat yang terkena COVID.
Karena saya tinggal di Queens.
Yeah, we didn't know. Now we're learning a lot more. So someone like you, I would encourage anybody that feels sick to make sure they get help before 10 days, because we can treat people before 10 days.
Seperti Dr. Flores bilang, jadi sangat-sangat direkomendasikan kalau Bapak atau yang lain merasa tidak sehat atau sakit untuk segera mencari perawatan dan tidak menunggu 10 hari. I just would like to translate what he said before.
Yes, please.
This is why I would like to share my personal experience from getting COVID. And then
I thank him for that. Please thank him for that. Because,
terima kasih banyak Bapak David.
Ini waktu saya pergi ke CTMD, mm-hmm. itu oksigen di tubuh saya itu ada sekitar 40%.
When I went to CDMD, I was told that the oxygen level in my body was only 40%.
That's incredible. That's so incredible.
Yeah,
sometimes it changes when you go back into the hospital where the equipment is better. But that really, you were very, very, very sick. I'm so happy you're with us.
Jadi Bapak pada saat itu Bapak sangat sakit ya Bapak. Dokter Flores sangat senang Bapak sudah bisa kembali lagi dengan kita semua. Go ahead Dr. Flores.
He got everything that we knew could work at that time.
Jadi Bapak David mempunyai semua simptom yang kita pikirkan pada saat ini ya dari COVID virus tersebut.
I do want to ask and encourage him to make sure that he gets vaccinated because even if you've had COVID, you don't keep the protection. The only way you keep protection is if you get vaccinated.
Bapak David, Dr. Flores ingin menyampaikan bahwa sangat penting sekali Bapak mendapatkan vaksin. Jadi walaupun Bapak sudah pernah mendapatkan COVID, sudah pernah terserang COVID, Bapak tidak aman sebelum Bapak mendapatkan vaksinasi.
Ya, saya sudah dapat vaksin dari Pfizer.
Oh, he received a Pfizer vaccine.
Congratulations. Yes,
from,
selamat.
From Beth Israel, Monsonai.
Good.
In Mount Sinai.
Two doses.
Yeah. Dua dosis ya, Bapak.
Two doses.
The first dosis April. April and the second one on 27. April 27.
So yeah. You're completely vaccinated. Congratulations.
The second dose is on April 27th. That's why he said so presumably the first dose is beginning of April. And then Bapak David, selamat untuk sudah mendapatkan vaksin.
Once he's 14 days after the second dose, completely vaccinated. Congratulations.
Dan 14 hari setelah 27 April itu Bapak secara penuh sudah divaksinasi. Jadi selamat.
And thank you very much. Thank you very much for sharing this with us.
Tapi saya juga belum yakin kalau vaksin ini udah benar-benar bisa mencegah begitu. Saya masih ada rasa khawatir, tapi walaupun saya udah divaksin, saya tetap pakai masker.
Okay.
He has a bit of a concern. He's still not sure. He's still not confident that even though I was vaccinated with two fully dose, I don't feel confident that I'm not going to get COVID anymore or I can't be free of COVID.
I am not surprised. He doesn't have the virus anymore, but he had so many things that he still has to work on. I'm not surprised.
So what he's saying, sorry, I said that. So even though he got vaccine, so that's why he still keeps his mask on. Jadi Bapak David, Dr. Flores bilang itu tidak jarang ya Pak ya. Jadi apa yang Bapak punya itu?
I would say unless he's around fully vaccinated people, he should keep his mask on.
Jadi kalau Bapak ada di sekitar orang yang sudah divaksinasi, baru Bapak tidak perlu memakai masker.
Maybe by September we'll have more people vaccinated and he'll be more comfortable.
Mudah-mudahan untuk semua orang akan bisa divaksinasi dan sudah mau divaksinasi pada bulan September.
Okay, thank you. I think we have more
terima
questions.
Kasih, terima kasih Bapak. Kita punya pertanyaan lagi.
Ya, yeah, itu karena saya merasa belum yakin dengan akan vaksin ini karena saya itu punya dua teman itu yang saya kehilangan dua teman karena faktor COVID-19 ini.
That's why I'm not really confident about these vaccines. I had lost two friends from this COVID.
Yeah, I would say so far this vaccine has been around since January. We have almost 9 months of trial. In those 9 months, vaccinated people have not died or gotten severely sick.
Oke, okay, ya Bapak, beliau mengerti, tapi vaksin ini sudah terbukti sejak Januari bahwa yang sudah divaksinasi tidak sakit atau tidak dirawat inap atau tidak sakit keras.
And those people that have tested positive after vaccination have had very, very mild disease.
Dan semua orang
or no symptoms.
Dan semua orang yang sudah divaksinasi tetapi tetap mendapatkan COVID positif, mereka itu tidak merasakan sakit keras atau simptomnya tidak terlalu parah.
Okay, thank you. I'm going to go on to Yerelix to help ask some more questions.
Ini apa namanya?
Terima kasih Bapak. Terima kasih Bapak David. Maaf kita harus lanjut ke pertanyaan yang lain. Terima kasih Bapak David.
Okay.
Go thank ahead. You so
thank
much.
You. Thank you for
thank you.
Terima
thank
kasih.
Thank you.
Thank you David thank for you. All your for sharing and for your questions.
Tremendous.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So there's a question from Kissy T. It says, "Hi, my 12-year-old daughter just received the first dose of the vaccine."
Okay. Congratulations.
Yes. I know that there are rare cases with adults getting COVID after vaccination. Mm-hmm. Do you think kids can get it too, even when they're fully even when they receive full vaccination? What are the chances?
Okay. I'm going to start by saying congratulations. You've done a good thing for your 12-year-old.
Thank you.
Oh, okay. Oh, do we have to translate or should we just, translate for everybody else? Yeah.
Okay.
So you translate.
Go ahead. I'm sorry, Dr. Flores. Can we repeat that again?
I was congratulating her for taking this step. Many parents are afraid naturally. It's a natural thing. It's going to take a while, but she went out there and did the right thing. So congratulations.
Selamat untuk Ibu Kisi yang sudah memberikan vaksinasi dosis pertama kepada anak Anda yang berumur 12 tahun. Karena saya mengerti banyak orang tua yang masih belum yakin untuk memberikan vaksinasi kepada anak mereka.
In children, and these are adolescents, in children, we've seen COVID at a much, much smaller rate than in adults. Much less.
Jadi untuk COVID, saya melihat rate yang sangat tipis atau sangat kecil di anak-anak dan di remaja.
Can they get COVID like we do after we're vaccinated?
Probably. Apakah anak-anak atau remaja ini bisa mendapatkan COVID setelah mereka divaksinasi? Mungkin.
Again, what they can do is pick up the virus, have no symptoms and give it to someone else.
Jadi yang akan terjadi kemungkinan adalah mereka bisa dapat virusnya dan tidak ada simptom tapi bisa menularkan kepada orang lain.
But they're not going to get sick and they're not going to be in the hospital.
Tetapi karena sudah divaksinasi, mereka tidak akan merasa sakit atau dirawat inap ke rumah sakit.
Yeah. And I think I'm frozen. And oh, I'm not frozen anymore. So and it the information so far.
Informasi yang sejauh ini.
From the tests, all the scientific testing.
Dari riset atau uji coba di.
On children shows that they have 100% efficacy. That the vaccine works better in children than it does in adults. So far.
Menurut riset mereka, vaksinasi yang diberikan kepada anak-anak jauh lebih efisiensi.
So, I'm very hopeful that the children are not going to be as symptomatic or carriers. But we'll see.
Dan saya punya harapan yang tinggi bahwa anak-anak tidak akan mendapatkan COVID. Tapi kita lihat nanti.
Thank you.
Terima kasih.
Thank you. Okay. I'm very happy to hear it. Thanks so much.
Terima kasih. Saya senang dengan jawabannya. Terima kasih.
Okay. And there's another question here from Damar. It says.
Ada pertanyaan dari Damara.
It says, "Hello, I'm here with my husband on Zoom. I'm 20 weeks pregnant."
Saya bersama suami saya di Zoom webinar ini. Saya 20 minggu hamil.
As I heard, COVID vaccines haven't been tested on pregnant women yet.
Dan seperti yang saya dengar, vaksin COVID belum diuji coba kepada wanita yang hamil.
And so there's I'm just going to read off the questions. There's a couple of questions.
Sure.
How safe are the vaccines for pregnant women, or should I delay until the baby is born? Can the vaccine affect my fetus during pregnancy?
Okay, so I'll take all the pregnancy questions now.
Okay.
I will start by saying that the vaccine is definitely being tested in pregnant women.
vaksin tersebut sedang diuji coba di wanita hamil.
Full results are not available yet.
Tetapi hasil belum belum ada, belum available.
But we know a couple of things that are very important.
Tapi kita tahu beberapa hal yang sangat penting.
First of all,
satu,
getting COVID when you are pregnant is very dangerous to both the pregnant person and the fetus.
Jika mendapatkan COVID, hal tersebut sangat berbahaya bagi ibu yang mengandung dan jabang bayi yang dikandung.
It can cause major complications and prematurity.
Bisa menyebabkan komplikasi dan prematur.
There have been women that have received, many women have received the COVID vaccine already.
The pregnant women, Dr. Flores?
Pregnant women have received COVID vaccine, yes.
Okay. Jadi sudah banyak wanita yang hamil mendapatkan vaksin COVID.
It is recommended for.
Sangat direkomendasikan.
It is recommended for pregnant persons.
Sangat direkomendasikan untuk wanita hamil.
And it's so far. And so far.
Dan sejauh ini.
We're finding that they have protection for themselves and for the baby.
Dan sejauh ini vaksin tersebut menjaga atau memberikan perlindungan kepada ibu yang hamil dan jabang bayi yang dikandung.
A woman that's lactating, that's breastfeeding, also should get the vaccine because it protects the baby through her milk.
Dan wanita yang menyusui juga direkomendasikan untuk mendapatkan vaksin karena melindungi bayi tersebut hubungan bayi ke air susu ibu.
And COVID is very dangerous for children under 6 months.
Dan COVID sangat berbahaya untuk anak-anak di bawah umur atau bayi di bawah umur 6 bulan.
I always suggest that you go back to your medical team and discuss this with them. Discuss your interest in the vaccine and see what they say. I always suggest that. It's important to do that.
Sugesti saya selalu kembali kepada dokter Anda dan tim kesehatan Anda apa yang harus dilakukan tentang COVID dan vaksinasi.
But remember that the CDC and Department of Health recommend that pregnant women be vaccinated.
Tetapi selalu ingat bahwa CDC dan Departemen Kesehatan merekomendasikan bahwa wanita yang hamil divaksin, diberikan.
Don't wait. Talk to your medical team.
I'm sorry.
Don't wait. Talk to your medical team.
Jadi segera untuk menghubungi dokter Anda atau tim kesehatan Anda.
Okay, I think I answered it.
Yes. Kalau menurut saya sudah menjawab.
Next.
And there was another part to the question that you may have answered already, but I'll read it just in case. Mm-hmm. It says, which vaccine should I choose and which week should I get the vaccine?
Okay. So,
jadi vaksin mana yang saya harus pilih? Pertanyaan lanjut dari Ibu Damar Wibowo. Vaksin mana yang saya harus pilih?
Yeah, it's incredible that we're in a place that we can choose a vaccine when our brothers and sisters in other countries don't even have vaccine. It's incredible, but we can.
Kita sangat beruntung bahwa kita bisa memilih option kita vaksin mana yang harus kita ambil, di mana saudara-saudara kita di negara-negara lain sama sekali tidak bisa mendapatkan vaksin.
At this point, there is enough vaccine that you can choose.
Pada saat ini banyak vaksin kesediaan vaksin yang Anda bisa pilih.
The only thing I would recommend is the following.
Yang saya bisa rekomendasikan adalah sebagai berikut.
We've heard that there were some very, very, very few cases of bleeding disorders with the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. Very, very few. 1 in 1 million, practically.
Kami mendengar bahwa 1 dari 1 juta adanya bleeding disorder bulan bleeding disorder.
But these
kelainan pendarahan.
Yeah. But these were very serious. These few cases were very very serious.
Beberapa kasus ini sangat serius dari Johnson & Johnson.
So the vaccine Johnson & Johnson has been found to be safe.
Tetapi vaksin Johnson & Johnson sudah ditemukan aman.
But we doctors have learned the following.
Tetapi kami para dokter sudah mempelajari
that if you are uncomfortable and if you're given a choice,
jika Anda merasakan nyaman atau diberikan pilihan,
and you're a woman under 50 years old,
dan Anda seorang wanita di bawah umur 50 tahun,
you might want to choose Pfizer or Moderna over Johnson & Johnson.
Disuggesti Anda memilih Pfizer and Moderna daripada Johnson & Johnson.
None of the complications with Johnson & Johnson were seen in men.
Efek samping yang ditemukan di Johnson & Johnson tidak ditemukan di Pfizer atau Moderna.
Remember, there are very, very few complications. So mostly Johnson & Johnson is fine and safe.
Dikarenakan komplikasi yang ditemukan di Johnson & Johnson sangat jarang, jadi kita bisa simpulkan bahwa Johnson & Johnson aman.
But if you're uncomfortable, you have a choice. You can take Moderna and Pfizer. They're made differently. The technology is different from Johnson & Johnson.
Tapi jika Anda diberikan pilihan dan Anda merasa nyaman, Anda diperbolehkan, dipersilakan untuk memilih Moderna atau Pfizer. Mereka menggunakan teknologi yang berbeda dari Johnson & Johnson. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Thank you. So I see a question here from Amalia. I don't know if Amalia, you want to ask your question verbally or if one of the interpreters would like to read the question.
Yeah. So my question is actually for the kid, is it the same dose with the adult? Is it like the dose of the vaccine is actually depend on their age or?
That's a really the same. Yeah. You're going to translate.
untuk pertanyaan Amalia, terima kasih Bu Amalia. Bertanya apakah dosis yang diberikan kepada anak-anak dan dewasa berbeda? Dan dosis tersebut apakah diperbedakan karena umur?
That's an excellent question, and I always.
Pertanyaan yang
excellent
bagus.
Question. Yeah, and it's one that I think about a lot because I'm a pediatrician.
Saya memikirkan hal tersebut sering karena saya seorang dokter anak.
But in most vaccines in children that are 12 and over, the dose is the same for the child as the adult once they're about 12, because they have enough weight.
Jadi dosis vaksin yang diberikan kepada anak umur 12 sama dengan dewasa.
Under 12 is a different story.
Dikarenakan mereka mempunyai berat badan yang hampir sama. Bukan hampir sama, maksudnya sudah mempunyai berat badan yang cukup. Tetapi berbeda dengan anak yang di bawah umur 12 tahun.
The vaccines are not tested yet or ready for children under 12. But that's going to come.
Tapi tiga vaksin ini belum diuji coba untuk anak umur 12 tahun, untuk anak-anak umur 12 tahun, dan saya berharap akan segera.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Terima kasih. Sama-sama.
And there's a question from Yanti that says, is the Johnson & Johnson vaccine going to be available soon for children 10 years and above?
Ada pertanyaan dari Yanti bahwa akankah vaksin bisa didapatkan untuk anak di bawah umur 10 tahun?
Okay. Johnson & Johnson has never been tried in anyone. The trials have not been in anyone under 18 years of age, so I don't think that they're ready for that. It will be Pfizer for now.
Jadi untuk Johnson & Johnson belum pernah ada uji coba secara klinis mengenai vaksin yang diberikan kepada anak umur 12 tahun maupun 10 tahun. Jadi untuk saat ini pilihan untuk anak di bawah umur 18 tahun hanya Pfizer saja.
Thank you.
Terima kasih.
And there's another question that says, what is the efficacy of these vaccines against current variants?
Oh,
say again.
How well do these vaccines work with the COVID-19 vaccine variants that COVID-19 mm-hmm. variants that are coming mm-hmm. out?
Okay. Jadi bagaimana vaksin-vaksin yang sudah ada sekarang di Amerika ini bekerja melawan jenis-jenis COVID yang lain?
So my message is going to be very simple.
Jadi pesan saya ini akan sangat simpel.
The best protection against variants is to get more people vaccinated.
Untuk melawan variasi-variasi COVID yang ada adalah mendapatkan vaksin.
Viruses mutate. That's their job.
Jadi tugas dari virus itu adalah memang bermutasi.
They work at getting better and better at making you sick.
Virus-virus ini bekerja dan bertugas untuk terus berkembang, bermutasi, dan membuat diri kita sakit.
So far, all the three vaccines that we have in the United States are working well against the variants.
Sejauh ini, ketiga vaksin yang sudah ada di Amerika Serikat ini bekerja sangat baik untuk melawan COVID dan dengan berbagai macam variasinya.
That's the Indian virus, the UK virus, a variant, the Brazil variant, and the New York variant.
Jadi ada berbagai macam variasi untuk COVID itu sekarang ada COVID variasi versi India, COVID versi India, versi UK, versi Brazil, bahkan versi New York.
And South Africa, forgot. South Africa.
Dan juga Afrika Selatan, versi Afrika Selatan.
So far, the vaccines are effective, but if we give them too much time, these viruses are going to get stronger and the vaccines will not protect us fully.
Jadi sejauh ini semua vaksin itu bekerja aman dan efektif melawan COVID dan variasi-variasinya. Jadi sebaiknya kita mendapatkan vaksin supaya kita semua bisa melawan COVID dan variasi-variasinya. Jadi kita tidak memberikan peluang untuk virus tersebut bermutasi lagi.
One of the good things about these vaccines and the fact that they're simple to make.
Jadi, I'm sorry, say again.
One of the advantages of these vaccines being so simple to make.
Jadi beberapa hal keuntungan yang diperoleh adalah karena vaksin-vaksin ini dibuat dengan cara yang cukup simple.
Is that if we need to develop booster shots to the variants, they can be developed very easily. And maybe we'll need a booster shot next year.
Jadi apabila kita membutuhkan suntikan atau dosis booster untuk memperkuat perlindungan terhadap variasi-variasi ini, kita dengan mudahnya membuat vaksinasi booster untuk melawan COVID variasi-variasi lain.
Thank you.
Terima kasih.
Terima kasih.
Thank you. So I don't see any more questions or comments, but if anyone has any other questions or comments, please put them in the chat or you can unmute yourself and ask verbally.
Anda mempunyai pertanyaan lagi, bisa ditulis di bagian chat di bawah atau dengan mengangkat tangan diberikan pertanyaan secara verbal.
And if there aren't any more comments or questions, then we can also move to close the conversation.
Jika tidak ada lagi komentar atau comments atau pertanyaan, kita bisa lanjut ke closing, ke penutupan.
All right. So I just want to say thank you so much to everyone who was present today. Thank you so much, Dr. Flores, for your presentation.
Terima kasih untuk semua yang sudah bergabung di webinar malam hari ini. Terima kasih untuk Dr. Flores. Terima kasih untuk presentasinya.
And thanks so much to the interpreters for all of their hard work this evening.
Terima kasih untuk para penerjemah. Terima kasih Wulan untuk kerja kerasnya.
And thank you to our community partners, including the Endangered Language Alliance, for helping put this together.
Terima kasih juga untuk organisasi masyarakat Endangered Language Alliance.
And Tevi and Wulan, any final comments or things that you want to say before we end the call?
Thank you everyone for joining in, and let's get vaccinated. We can do this together.
Yes, please.
So hashtag New York Strong. Okay, I think that's it coming from me. Thank you so much for having us. And thank you for this amazing and insightful presentation. I'm pretty sure all of this is useful for all of us, for our community, especially.
It's very useful, and thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Oh, Dr. Flores, you're on mute.
I was just thanking everybody for being such wonderful companions in this conversation. Thank you, Yerelix, and definitely thank you, the translators and participants.
Thank you. Thank
good
you.
Night.
Thank Have you. A great night.
Have a good night, everyone.
Have a great night. Bye. Bye. Be safe. Stay safe.
Bye-bye. Be safe. Get vaccinated, please. Please.
All right. Thank you. Bye-bye. Good night.
Thank you, David.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.